Hi, welcome to Harmony with Su-Lynn. In this tutorial, I'll be showing you paperless animation. This is the same as traditional drawn animation or frame-by-frame animation. I'll be teaching you how to fly. I'll show you the key poses that you'll need to create a bird flying on the spot, and later we'll do some keyframe animation to create hybrid animation. So let's start. The asset you'll need is a drawing of a bird. I have a robin design, and in my timeline, I have one drawing layer, which I've called robin_rough. You can see I have one drawing, which is on two frames, because we're going to be working on twos, which is 12 frames per second. Over here, you can add key exposure or remove key exposure. You can create an empty drawing, and that's what we'll do in the start, and next to it is the duplicate drawing. When you make an empty drawing, you'll have to put onion skin on, so you can see your previous frame or your previous drawing. And you can change those settings to the opacity you would like. We're going to use the brush because it's rough animation, and you can choose a color. When you're creating rough animation, don't worry too much about tidying up because that will be the next stage. So the first drawing we're going to create is the bird with the wing in the upward position. When the wing is in the upward position, the body dips slightly in the air. We're going to draw 9 frames for the cycle and note the position of the body and the circling movements of the wings. The body dips slightly in the air on frame 1 as the wing is in the upward position. So that's our first drawing and our first frame. You can have a look at your drawings in the Xsheet, and if you don't have that, hit the plus sign, look for Xsheet. We're working on twos, so we're going to need to put in another frame by selecting Fill Empty Cells, or you can go to the shortcut F5. So once our first keyframe is drawn, we can go to frame 5, select the brush. When you start drawing, it automatically creates a drawing for you, or you can create an empty drawing and then start drawing with your brush tool. With the onion skin on, you can see that the position of the body moves slightly up as the wing starts to come down. Remember, we're looking at small increments of movement. Don't worry too much about tidying up lines at this stage. This is just the rough animation stage. You can bring up the light box by holding down Option and Command to rotate, and this may be easier for you to draw. We can create another frame by hitting F5 and then move to the next frame. So we're on frame 7. Create an empty drawing or just start to draw and it will create our frame for us. You can copy and paste certain parts of the drawing if it's the same and paste it into the next frame. Just adjust the position of the wing. So we can see on frame 7, the wing is starting to move downward and the body is moving slightly upward. On the next frame, frame 9, we can repeat the process. This time, we're going to be drawing a breakdown position. The breakdown position is an important key pose which shows the wing going from the upward position to the downward position. It's important to get the perspective right on this drawing so you can see the wingtips rolling upwards. We can check how our animation is looking and we can see it's coming together nicely. You can move your playhead using your keyboard shortcuts, which are the comma and the dot. Let's add another frame using F5 and then let's move on. We'll continue with the frames as the wing moves downward. So on frame 13, we can see that the wing is coming down and the body is moving slightly upward. In frame 15, the wing is completely down. You can extend your onion skin in the tools at the top, or you can drag your onion skin in the timeline. On frame 17, we have another breakdown when the wing starts to move upward from the downward position. Again, we have to draw in perspective so that the wing looks like it is rolling. As the wing moves up, the wingtips are folding back on themselves. One more frame to go. On frame 19, the wing is in the upward position and the body dips ever so slightly downward. We can add another frame to put it on twos. And now let's test the animation. We only have to draw up to frame 20 because then we can put on loop playback and test the cycle. We can take a look at how that looks in the Xsheet, and we can also mark it with keyframes and breakdowns. So on frame 3, I'm putting in a keyframe. And frame 9, I'm putting in a B for the breakdown position. And this just tells us and marks the storytelling keys. Frame 17 is also another breakdown. And frame 19 is a keyframe. So the storytelling keys tell us how a movement works, going from one position to the other. And this is useful so you can identify very quickly which are your key poses and which ones are your breakdowns, in case you need to make changes. The next stage is to duplicate that layer. Right-click on the drawing layer, duplicate selected layer. Now we have two identical drawings. What we're going to do is to keep the timing of that drawing layer, so all the timing of the frames that we've drawn, but we're going to unpaint, so using the unpaint tool, the duplicated layer. We can use apply to all frames, just circle the drawing, and it will immediately unpaint that layer, and we can check it by just taking off the eye on the layer underneath. Let's put the light table on. We can change the opacity settings to suit us using the top light. Let's go with the pencil, and this is the cleanup tool. Choose our settings for the size and also choose the color that you would like to clean up with. I'm going to choose the color black. You can visit my tutorial on the pencil tool for more details. Remember, with the pencil tool, you don't have to have complete accuracy. You can use the contour editor to refine the drawing. Use the light box to rotate for those awkward positions when you're drawing. So we'll continue until we've cleaned up all our drawings. In the next stage of the paperless animation workflow is the stage called Shift and Trace. And this is a great way to make sure that your drawings are consistent and that you have volume control. To use Shift and Trace, you'll need to make sure onion skin is on. You then select the drawing panel, and here you can see your drawing with the onion skin. Select the first frame and send drawings to desk. It opens up the Shift and Trace panel. The first button at the top is Shift and Trace Enable. The second is Shift and Trace Manipulator. And the third is to reset, and the fourth is to link drawings. We're going to send another drawing to the desk, and this time we can use the shortcut, hold down Option, and click on the frame in the Xsheet. Now we have two drawings, and we can enable Shift and Trace. When you're using Shift and Trace, whatever amendments you make will not change anything in the camera view. So the position of the frames as a sequence will not change. With the Shift and Trace manipulator, you can rotate your drawings, you can move them up and down, and you can scale them, and you can reset. When you see your drawings on top of each other, you can see the parts that are not on model or need to be adjusted to make them consistent. So you can rotate as well on parts that are animated, but when you check in the camera, nothing changes in terms of the position. You can remove selected drawings once you're finished with them, and add new drawings, holding down Option and clicking on the frame. So you're making adjustments using the contour editor. When you're finished using Shift and Trace, you can remove all drawings from the desk. Once you finish cleaning up and tying down your model, you can start on the character breakdown. And this is separating out all the parts of your character into pieces. So for my character, the robin, I've separated out the beak, the eye, the front wing, the body, and the back wing in preparation to add color. You can visit my tutorial on the paint tool for more details. We can see that each layer has its own column in the Xsheet. If we select the beak, we can go to the drawing layer and see that only the beak is in that layer. We can also use stroke, shortcut K, to see that all gaps are closed. Once we do that, we're ready to add color. Now let's add color. Let's select the eye and choose Make Color Art from Line Art. Select on the Color Art layer, choose the color, I have some pre-made, and then select the Paint tool and drop in the color. Once we have our paperless animation and we've created our flying cycle, we can take it one step further by creating a hybrid animation. Over here, you can see the character breakdown drawings. You can click and drag to select all the drawings and add a peg, shortcut Command P. And then place the rotation point. You can visit my tutorial on rigging the arm for more in-depth information on keyframe animation. Collapse the layers by hitting 0. To show all layers, it's 9. Select the peg and make the first keyframe, or shortcut F6. First of all, we can scale our robin and make it a little bit smaller for our scene. On the first keyframe, let's start with the robin off-screen. I've got my camera mask on, so I can see my actual screen space. With the playhead on the last keyframe, let's now make another keyframe and move the robin to the right-hand side of the screen. And now let's set motion keyframes and test the animation. And there you have a hybrid animation, which is a combination of paperless animation and keyframe animation. Check out my tutorial on multiplane backgrounds to enhance the depth and visual appeal of your animation. And that's it for paperless animation. See you next time.